since I'm an MFA student, I forgot to print, of course, sorry. This first one is for Brandon Knight. She was a work poet that we lost this August. She was a big voice in the community. In memory of Brea, Blackberry Molaasez Knight drips slow like molasses. The Caper kids are crying tonight because one of our stars had burned out in Leo's eye. One filled of fiery brown sugar turned to liquid sweetness in my ear. I, stellar starlight, that is no longer marveled but remembered. Our hearts hurt slowly because there is a visual for a voice, a brick and mortar kind, with Neptune's looks and Venus's grace. I was a follower of hers in the cosmos of her voices. I knew her as a myth, a legend, to our tribe of mouths that screamed to be heard with hopes of one day becoming paths, whereas we will now cross suns. But alas, tonight, like the phasing out of a dying star, my heart will bleed and drip slow like molasses. This one's called Assessment of the Urban Dollar. Paper currency, the dollar green ink on the dollar green paper that makes others without them green with envy. It's the difference between expensive but fresh produce or value menu McDonald's hamburger that costs those factories cents to create, but shh, they say it's a secret. Says the man at the bus stop talking to his friend about them trading EBT credit for hard-earned dollars. Man prides himself on affording skirt steak, put it on my card. Another man has child starving empty in new Air Jordans. Clothes, voyeurisms, technology, visuals, disposables. Similar to a throwaway razor wielded by a suit man and bought for a dollar as he sits next to me on the bus, frantically trimming the hair around his white collar. He maintains his presentable appearance in an unpaid two-piece charged on tender, supporting the company that grants him access to better opportunity because of their newly mandated minority quota. The sign above the quasi-barber reads, "Where will your child be at 4 p.m.? Easy answer, of course, for any children embracing the festered system of the green dollar. Buying an afternoon snack of an overpriced bag of chips and soda, everything to keep their motor running and their bodies crashing. I conclude with a transit belt and a step off the bus that so much depends on the dollar, if only I had a dollar." Alright, this one is in response to a meme about plastic bags and reusable bags. It's a picture of this young boy, about 4 or 5 in India, saying reduce, reuse, recycle, and he's wearing a plastic bag instead of clothes. Third world awareness with first world action. A picture of a vulnerable boy, photographed, unknowing the touch of cotton, the stretch of nylon, the scratch of wool, the potential of youth malnourished, his bones asphyxiated by the skin, tightly wrapped around small organs. Others share in his hopelessness, antiquated reconstructions, built against themselves with shit and assorted plastics. He used them as overalls, feeling the dirt between his toes that keeps him close to the ground. So he is over there, and I am right here, staring at this photograph on a computer screen. I'm a card-carrying vegan, and there's a poem about me being a meat manager in a store while being vegan. It's terrible. The meat man. Another day that mercury floods my brain, while the nasal passages fill with the scent of nickel, the soft, filled floor of yesterday's spoils, devalued life mirrors my own. A meat mix of wasted lifetime cutting, gutting out a carcass until raw bone emptiness. These people are starving, yells Bossman. So I provide provisions of provisional nourishment, but they can never consume enough of their meat. The energy is already wasted in another vessel and floats in a scarlet ocean of cruelty and murder that begins in my brainstem and courses down into my aorta. Throw it all in the grinder, Bossman says. So in goes my livers, skins, eyes, ears, lips, and lungs, becoming one body but not mine, for mine has already rotted. I keep getting messages while I'm reading those. This one is called, If Lazarus Was a Mouse, No One Would Give a Shit. This is what being human feels like. I picked it out of my drain. It was a clump of hair until I heard the crunch of tiny bones. I dropped it repulsed by the being who swallowed air like me. I thought about the lifelessness in my apartment, my cats playing with the dead. I thought of liquid ballooned in the lungs, its body was followed water with a tail. I wondered how it got there, past the soap scum, the hair, the lint, how it crawled up a second floor drain. I wondered if it tried to crawl away when an attraction to light was revealed as a sealed metal grid. I thought about claustrophobia, the PVC pipe diameters, the 2 inches of panicking girth that backed up my drain. I wondered about rodents and their many companions, exterminators, asbestos, wired mesh, rat poison, sticky traps. None note that death, the gravesite was rented, a 2-ply mummification with slushy eyes still open, yet it was flushable. Toilet paper wrapped around my hand, I've never drowned anyone before. All right, this is my last one. This one's about California happy cows. This one's entitled Real California Milk. I hear from others that behind closed doors, we are worshipped on a plate, and the glory of our fleshy sickness is how we get there. I'm a mother with no children. 5 pregnancies and bones have ossified, and I am happy to make my bed among the guts and dirt where lying down, my world finally begins to move. More flies around me than usual. They used to signal my next insemination, fling when a man arrived with their long metal rod. I never saw the face of my baby's daddy, but I imagined him in the seconds after my calves were born. The flies remind me as they gnaw at my leather. The pain helps recall yellow light and gray hands pressed pulling at my dainty legs. My first thump onto glazed concrete, I bled with scurrying limbs. I'm sprawled to witness new crownings of milk queens, gushing out, scrambled vaginas, mothering wails, babies yanked by bipedal freaks. On the ground, I'm away from taunting whites of small milk harvester eyes and the gunky tears of a mother's sob, guttural and ripping on a cold rack, warm, bloody nipples, machines fiery and tearing milk sacs, tissues running, pus and innards as they ingest our suffering. There is a loud buzzing that turns to beeping. I'm mooing in happiness. My world begins to move. I have stood standing since birth. Now I'm collapsed in a rusted bulldozer on broken legs. And it's okay. They will use them where I'm going. Thank you.